Express yourself. Brothers and sisters, comrades and friends, welcome to CubaLibre's Style Guide. I will be your style advisor for the fashion-conscious ninja. Styles are unlockable costumes that you obtain as you play through the game and unlock seals. They look different, so that's cool, but the important part is that they change your powers. They generally take the form of going with the default outfit and then saying you get an advantage and a disadvantage. So let's start with the only one you've also seen me use, the Path of the Mark. This is the story one that lets you teleport. Of course, the game forces you to use it in certain levels. The advantage is that you can teleport. It's pretty sweet. Disadvantage is that you cannot have a distraction item. You only have an attack item. So basically, the teleport replaces your distraction item slot. This is pretty good. To me, there's two uses of a distraction item. There's a defensive use and an offensive use. The defensive use is that there's a guy where you want to be, so you throw the distraction item to move him so you can get to where you want to go, get around the guard. And the teleport fills that gap perfectly. You can just teleport on past him. And you can do it infinitely instead of having a limited number of items. On the other hand, there are the offensive uses of distraction items, either using them to incapacitate the guards, in the case of especially the gas grenade, or just moving them to a place where you can then kill them. If they're in a place where killing them where they are is going to set off a bunch of alarms, a distraction item can help move them, lure them away to get them alone so you can kill them in safety. And obviously the teleport does not allow you to do that. So in my opinion, the teleport, while cool, is not as versatile as having a distraction item around. So I don't think it's an even trade at the end of the day. And you hear that a lot. Basically, if you're playing through the game like I am, sort of normally trying to be stealthy, but also killing everybody, I think the default outfit is the best. But you'll see why. Next is the Path of Might. Reinforced armor provides additional protection and knocks down opponents faster, while stealth kills now restore health. However, focus no longer stops time. So this is basically the combat outfit. If you just want to run around and beat the shit out of people, this is your thing. You can grab a stealth kill real quick to restore your health. You have more total health. And in open combat, where you have to fight enemies hand-to-hand, they get knocked over quicker, so you can kill them quicker. But since focus doesn't stop time, it's really tough to use your items. So you're just getting up in people's faces and fighting them. I think it should be obvious why this is weaker than a normal outfit. It's not conducive to stealth at all. And I guess it might be fun maybe on a lark to play the game this way, but you're not going to get any points for doing it. And I don't know, it's just not built for this, really. Maybe I think my least favorite outfit of all of them. Path of the Hunter. Two attack items can be carried, and all active stealth kills will automatically succeed. However, items will not be replenished at checkpoints. Arguably, this along with the teleportation thing, I think is the most useful for just a regular playthrough. It's arguably a side grade from the regular outfit rather than a downgrade. Two attack items is really nice later on when you're fighting the stalkers. However, the fact that your items don't get replenished at checkpoints means it's kind of six in one, half dozen the other. You're carrying around double the attack items to kill stalkers with, but you don't get any more when you get checkpoints. There are at least enough checkpoints throughout the levels where stalkers live to replenish your items, to replenish the same number of items that you're getting extra. So unless you need to front load the items for some reason, there's no real advantage here in my opinion. And of course you miss out on distraction items entirely. So, if you're speed running the game, maybe, but even then, you get the items back at checkpoints anyway, so I don't know. Again, not very useful, and it's not worth the price and versatility that you pay. Next, Path Silence. Running makes no noise, and two distraction items can be carried. However, there is no room for a sword. So, you actually can't kill anything. You cannot perform stealth kills with no sword, and you have no attack items to kill people. I guess the only way you could kill people is by doing it environmentally. Running them into traps and stuff. Obviously, this is just a custom designed suit for people who are ghosting the game. If you're trying to kill people, it's useless. But if you're trying to not kill people, it's just a pure upgrade. Silent running and two distraction items, that's awesome. You just get rid of all the stuff that kills people, which you don't need when you want to kill nobody. I plan on doing another LP of this game where I ghost it on New Game Plus much later. I have other things I want to do in between. And when I do that, I will probably exclusively use Path of Silence. Maybe also the teleport thing, but probably not. Especially since you have to carry an attack item with the teleport thing, and I would be avoiding kills. So this would pretty much be the way to go. Last but not least, Path of Nightmares. Enemies witnessing stealth kills become terrified, as do those that discover a dead body. However, you cannot equip any distraction items. To me, this is probably the best way to get points in the game. If you want to do the leaderboards and get the maximum number of points, this is probably the thing to use. You won't... The points you miss out on are negligible, and that is distraction points, because you have no distraction item. But you can terrorize almost every guard in the level. You can just cart around corpses and toss them at guards wherever you go, and it will terrify them. So it's like almost like 300 extra points on almost every guard in the level. And that's just plain... Otherwise, you're playing the exact same way I played. So, in my Let's Play up till now. So, it's the same as in my Let's Play up till now, except you get more points. Now, why don't I use it in my normal Let's Play? I don't like not having distraction items. It's harder to be stealthy all the time without them. I'm sure it's doable, but again, it's just not as versatile. If you're surprised by something, you're not going to be able to react as well. Perhaps the benefit of just all guards being terrified, which means no real alarms, or a lot fewer alarms, as long as you're killing guys in a quick fashion, means you might be able to stay stealthy, because no alarms will be triggered. They'll just find the body and freak out, instead of triggering the alarm. But, again, I just like the versatility of the main thing. But if you were to use this in the main game instead, I wouldn't really blame you. And that's it. Those are the six styles of Path of the Ninja. When I return, you will see the last stage in the game, followed by the ending and my fancy-schmancy plot analysis. So remember, kids, it's not what you're doing when you're doing what you're doing. It's what you're doing when you're doing what you look like you're doing. See you next mission.